This is what, okay, so recording is started now, so I can start your session. So friends, once again I welcome you back for my session, and we are in first lecture of EVS, which is called as environmental awareness. This one is a subject which is compulsory for SY students, those who are in there, who are there in SYBCOM, SYBA, SYBSC, SYBOK, SYBBA, SYBC also. For all those SY courses, this course is, you know, mandatory, this course is compulsory, and this is what this course is there for your syllabus also. So there may be the question, there may be a question in the mind of you guys, why this course is compulsory at this particular stage. Now we are in, you know, middle of our degree, first year is already done, and now you are going to appear for third year in next year. So you are in middle part or middle stage of your degree, and now you are studying this, which one, you know, this environmental awareness. So there are certain reasons behind making this course compulsory for your classes, and the reasons are very simple. As we know that as we are developing, as we are, you know, making progress in our day-to-day life, at the same time we are not taking care of environment, we are not taking care of nature. And this is what government or central government or state government or, you know, city grant commission, which is there in Delhi, they thought, why don't they introduce one course that will create awareness among the students, those who are in their graduation degrees. And this is an attempt of government to make you aware about the environment, and through this particular sort of awareness, we are going to, you know, take care of the environment, which is the most important aspect in our day-to-day life. As I told you, we guys have made a huge amount of progress, huge amount of development in our day-to-day life. We have shifted from rural area to urban area. Even in urban area also, we are, you know, living a very good standard life, and the cost of living is also improved, no doubt at all. So what happened? At the same time, we have started, you know, creating hazards for the nature. And when we started creating hazards for the natures, automatically natures also responded in a different terms. And those terms or those things are also we are suffering. We hear news, there is a flood or there is a flood situation in certain part of the country. And last week, or okay, I think if you have gone through the news of last 15 days, you might have observed that there was a flood situation or heavy flood situation in Andhra Pradesh and Telangana. And before that, in last year also, you guys have seen that in south, especially in Tamil Nadu and Kerala, there was a flood situation. In these days only, it was there in the month of November and December. Actually, November and December, these are the months of, you know, winter season, not rainy season as such. But in winter season also, there was a flood situation, there was a, you know, rainy situation or heavy rainfall in those areas of our country. So why this is happening, why it is happening, there are n number of reasons, and those reasons we are going to find out from our lectures. So this is my request to you all, be there for every session, and from these sessions I'm going to highlight, I'm going to tell you something about environment, why environment is necessary, how to take care of environment. There are n number of topics which we are discussing without fail, and mostly the lectures which are given to me, they are from your divisions, and this is what, you know, I'm here. So without wasting your time, I'm going to start my session. And for that, please allow me to share my screen. Before going to share my screen, let me ask you one question, whether my voice is clear for you all. Is my voice clear? Is my voice clear? Please answer.
Yes, sir.
Okay. If it is not there, if I lose my connection, if I lose my, you know, presentation, please let me know. You have my cell phone number. You can call me on my cell phone number directly if there is something technical sort of issue. So with this, I'm going to start my session. I hope you all are listening my session, and you guys have to listen anyhow. So with this, I'm going to share my screen. If my screen is visible, please let me know whether my screen is visible or not. Is it visible? Is my screen visible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So see, this is my humble request to you all. This is my humble request, and I hope you will understand my humble request. So whenever I will ask some questions, you guys have to answer my questions very quickly so that we can save our time. Because the time which is given to me is 11 to 11:40, and after that I'm having session from 12:40 to 1:20. These are my sessions. So what I'm going to suggest you, answer my questions in a very quicker manner. So we are going to start our session. So let me take this PPT on presentation mode or slideshow mode. So Rauda Bahardeva. So this is my session, and we are going to understand the environment. We guys have heard about the concept of environment. We guys have thought about the concept of environment, and we always think about environment. There are certain organizations, they are taking care of environment, as we know that. So when it comes to environment, just a minute, just let me get back to the home screen again so that I can stop my video. Okay. Now, is it visible? Is my screen visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we are going to understand the concept of environment in this first slide, as well as we are going to see what is environment and how the environment is, there, or for what we call it environment. There are certain things, there are n number of things which we are discussing in our sessions, in our lectures. So I want to make this class, I want to make this lecture, I want to make this session, which is online. I'm trying to make this session interactive. Interactive means you guys have to answer. In between, I will ask some questions, and you guys have to answer those questions whenever I ask you some questions. So before going to start, let me ask you one simple question. What do you mean by environment according to you? What do you mean by environment? We always talk about environment, environment, environment. So what do you mean by environment as far as your knowledge is concerned that we are discussing here? So come on, answer the question. Very simple question I have asked at the beginning of my session. What do you mean by environment? Come on, it's your time now. You guys have to answer the questions because we are trying to make it interactive. So see, I'll make your lectures interactive. I will show some videos in between. Today videos are not there because today we are going to see some theoretical aspects. But I will try my level best to make it very much interactive because environment is very interesting subject. We all are directly or indirectly associated with the environment, and without the environment we cannot imagine ourselves. So what do you mean by environment? That is the question. Tell me. You can answer your question, whatever question I'm asking to you guys, in Marathi, Hindi or English. There is no language barrier as such, but as far as my teaching is concerned, there is a language barrier. I cannot teach you in Marathi because the instruction of medium or medium of instruction is English, but you can answer your questions in Marathi, Hindi or English. There is no language barrier as such. So please come on. Come on and do it, please. What do you mean by environment? Environment means what? What is the composition of environment? What is the component of environment? What do you think? Come on, boys and girls, please come ahead and answer the questions.
Environment is the natural in which plant, animal, woman, and other living beings live and operate.
Very good. Please see, may I know your name?
Ria Agone.
Ria, you answered very well. Environment is nothing but what? Whatever plants we see, whatever human beings we see, whatever living plants we see, those can be called as environment. So we all are the part and parcel of this environment. See, human beings, even we people, means what we call it, human beings, then plants, trees, then small insects also, they are the part and parcel of this environment, correct? Is anyone wants to answer the question? Is there anyone who wants to contribute something in the answers? So see, you guys have to answer. तुम्हारा उत्तर दायित्व से कैसे ही दिया मराठी दिया इंग्रजी दिया हिंदी दिया because I know three languages so I expect answers in these three languages. So please come on and answer the questions. Do not bother. Do not feel any sort of botheration while answering the questions, whether it is right or wrong. चुकीता सुधा फरक पड़ना नहीं. So in whatever answer given by Ria, in short we can say whatever biodiversity is the word that we are going to see. Whatever biodiversity that we see around us, that is a part of environment, correct? In environment, so many things are there. So many things are included. Even the sand and even the soil, even the stones also, they are the part and parcel of environment. And they are the component of environment and those are the compositions of environment. So here in this definition of environment, we are going to understand the concept of environment. Even we are going to understand the definition of environment in a precise manner. So I'm going to read the definition. After that, I will explain the definition in a precise manner. So just look at the environment. The environment is the sum of the total of the elements, factors, and conditions in the surrounding which may have an impact on the development, action, or survival of an organism or group of organism such as human being, we human beings. So see what they have said, environment is nothing but what? Those are the elements, those are the factors, those are the conditions. For what? Of what? Those are the elements, those are the factors, those are the conditions which we can see in the surroundings. Surrounding means what? The things that we can see around us. That is called surroundings. So this element, factors and conditions are the part and parcel and the composition and the components of surroundings. And these elements, these factors, these conditions are going to create impact on the development, action and the survival of we people. We people means what? All the organisms which we can see on this planet Earth. So see, no doubt this planet Earth is the biggest part of this environment. But whatever human beings and organisms that we can see on the planet Earth, on those organisms and human beings, there are certain elements, there are certain factors, there are certain conditions which are affecting on those human beings, on those organisms. And that is called the environment. Environment is nothing but what? It is, or they are the elements, they are the factors, they are the conditions which are affecting on we people, which are affecting on organism and organs or the human beings of their survival purposes. So this is a small definition that we can see. In simple term, I would like to tell you something about environment. Environment is nothing but what? Whatever we see around us. And we people are also the part of environment because we are also, you know, living on the planet Earth. So whatever living organisms are there on the planet Earth, even human beings which are included in the organisms of the planet Earth, so those are the part and parcel of environment. And this is what I used one word at the beginning, biodiversity. So biodiversity is also the part of what? Environment. So, or I have, you know, taken this particular meaning of this definition in a brief manner that we can see, or it can also be defined as external surrounding and conditions which directly or indirectly affects the living organism. What I told you at the beginning only. So environment is nothing but what? Environment is nothing but what? Whatever surrounding we see around us, whatever conditions we see around us while living on this planet Earth, which are required directly or indirectly. See, we guys are living on this planet Earth, and directly we are taking something from the planet Earth, directly we are taking something from the nature that we can easily understand. But there are certain things, there are n number of things that we can consuming indirectly. We never know. These are the parcel of part and parcel of the environment, and we are getting it in a free of cost. Still, nature is not charging anything else for the services which are provided by the nature. Those services are free. Even, you know, see, water is free, air is free, then, you know, shadows which we are getting from the trees, those are also free. So see, these are the things which we are getting from the environment. And this is what here I have, you know, made a short meaning of word environment. And here what I have told you, external surroundings and conditions which directly or indirectly affects the living organism, which are directly and indirectly affecting on the all living organisms. It includes we people, it includes animal, it includes trees, it includes small insects also. So if it is going to create sort of effect on those kind of living organisms, it is called as environment. Nowadays we can see environment around us. I think early in the morning we can see fog. There are n number of reasons of having fog in the morning. Not only in the morning, we can see fog in the evening also. There are different reasons behind those kind of things we are going to see one by one. So, but from this first slide, what we have understood? We have understood the concept of environment in a precise and a detailed manner. I hope so. I hope you have understood in a thorough manner. Now, we are going to understand something different. And here, we are going to talk about scope of environmental studies. Why environmental studies are conducted? Why environmental studies are undertaken by the various people? And we know that there are so many people, they are talking about environment and they talk about environmental studies also. And now people are very much cautious. People are very much, you know, serious about the environmental losses which we are, you know, suffering. We know that environment is the part and parcel of our day-to-day life. We cannot see that. And in certain areas of our country, people are suffering from this kind of environmental changes. And why those things are happened? Why there is a huge change in the environment? You see, nowadays we can see rain in the month of December, rain in the month of November, which was not expected. Basically, these are the months of winter. Getting my point? But we, instead of experiencing winter, instead of experiencing cold in these months, we people are experiencing rain. So people are confused whether to wear a sweater or raincoat. Why it is happening? There are n number of reasons. There are n number of, you know, causes, and those causes we are going to understand. So here in this particular topic, or here in this particular point, which we are going to see, and that is scope of environmental studies. When we want to understand the scope of environmental studies, we need to understand how the studies are taken place, who were they, and what sort of studies they have conducted, and what were the results of the studies in short. So this is for scope purpose. So I'm going to read the scope in a precise manner. Environment is a subject matter, not only science, but also social and humanities. Whenever we talk about environmental awareness, environmental studies, for you all, most of the people, they think that environmental science or environment is a subject of faculty of science. But it is not like that. Environment is not the subject of, you know, science. It is a subject of common people. It is also there for social and humanities, social sciences and humanities. Social sciences and humanities means what? The subjects which are covered under the faculty of commerce and arts. So it is not a subject of science only. It is a common subject which everyone can experience. So remember what I'm going to tell you, what I'm going to suggest you. Environmental science is not a subject of science. It is a common subject which is also there for social sciences and humanities also. So first of all, you will have to remove one thought from your mind. And what is that thought? It is not a science subject only. It is a subject of social sciences also. And nowadays, it is a subject of humanities also. Because everyone has to understand, everyone has to study this, everyone has to learn this subject, because there is a use of this subject in their day-to-day life. If they try to learn how to protect the environment, how to create an awareness about the environment in their life, definitely they can protect the environment, because environment is not a subject of some people. It is a subject of we all. And if we take a precaution, if we take a care of our environment, it will be most useful for all of us. As I said earlier, anything we can see in each month, or see, there are no seasons because of the loss that we are making with the environment. I think if you ask your parents, they used to say there were three seasons: rainy season, which is also called as monsoon, winter, and summer. But nowadays we are experiencing something different. We experience rain in the month of November. We experience rain in the month of October. We experience rain in the month of March, January also. So seasons are not there. And why seasons are not there? Because we guys have created something wrong with the environment. We guys have did something wrong with the environment. And this is what we cannot experience such kind of things. Or we cannot experience proper seasons. So a number of things we are going to see in the topic pollution. Before that, let me talk about the scope of environment only. The study of environment, to know physics, chemistry, biology, geography, management, economics, and population issue of the country. Whenever we go for the environment is not only, you know, nature and rocks that we see around. Environment is everything. Environment includes so many things. We can include physics also, we can include chemistry also, we can include biology also. Then we can also go for geography, we can go for management, we can go for economics, we can also go for certain topics which are related to environment in this particular thing. So environment is a very broad concept. Some people, they said that environment is a topic of science. Not, it is not a topic of science only, it is a topic of commerce subject also, it is a topic of, you know, art subjects also. So make it broad, and now make this concept in your mind broad. Next one, save environment for present and future generation. Look at this. Why we are taking care of environment? Why this subject is launched or introduced for your syllabus? There is one reason. Because if we take care of environment in the right manner, if we take care of environment in a proper manner, then only we can save environment for our future generation. Most of the time, what happened, you know, most of the time we are just making hazards with the environment. And if we do so, there will not be a sort of environment for our future generation. And future generation will definitely blame us for not protecting the environment. So it is our duty to protect the environment. It is our duty to conserve natural resources, to conserve water, to conserve oil, to conserve, you know, n number of things, energy also. And this is what, if we protect the environment, automatically we can protect the environment of our future generation. And the last one, protect and preserve environment resources like water, food, fuel, and control degradation of environment. As I told you earlier, if we protect n number of things which we can see around us, definitely those are useful. And for doing that, definitely we can do a number of things. No doubt, whatever resources, especially natural resources that we see around us, those are limited. There is a limit, and those are going to over one day. And if we go for excessive or massive use of those resources, one day those will be definitely over. And this is what we are trying to find out some other options. As we know that petrol and diesel and whatever oil, natural oils we can see around us, those are going to over one day. And if those things or those petrol and diesels will be over in one day, what will happen? We won't have, you know, fuel for running our vehicles on the road. So this is what we are trying to find out some solutions for that. And this is what we have started using CNG. We have started using vehicles on electricity. So we have started other options, and because of that, these things are happening. So my suggestion is what? If we try to protect and if we try to preserve environmental resources like water, food, fuel, and control degradation of environment, it will be useful. And those are there in the scope of the studies. We guys have seen that in certain areas of Maharashtra, if you take an example of Maharashtra, in certain areas of Maharashtra, there is a huge amount of water. And if you visit certain areas of Maharashtra, we can see there is no water. People run five kilometers for getting the water, or getting one, you know, what do we call it? One jar of water. Why it is happening? Because there is no proper management of rainwater system. So people are just spending their half day for getting the water, because there is no water as such. And this is what I told you, if we protect, if we preserve water for our future generation, they will not have any problem as such of water resources in days to come. Even we can go for food preservation, we can go for fuel preservation. So n number of things are there that we can do under the scope of environment, and those we are going to see in upcoming lectures one by one. Now, there are n number of elements, there are n number of points, there are n number of factors which are there in the environment, and those are the part and parcel of environment. Don't forget this thing. And by getting all those things at one place, environment is there. So as far as environment is concerned, if you look at the diagram that is there in my slide, from that also we can see environment is what. And there are n number of layers. If you want to understand the concept of environment, there are n number of layers. We call it, you know, sthar in Marathi. There are n number of layers, and those layers are made the environment. So first layer is called as stratosphere, atmosphere, troposphere. There are n number of, you know, sphere, those we are going to see. The stratosphere is what? This stratosphere is, that also we are going to discuss. It is above troposphere and extend up to 50 to 55 kilometer. So this particular stratosphere is just above the troposphere, and it is just up to 50 to 55 kilometers. Here you can see, look at this. This one is the troposphere, and after that you can see this red line. Then here you can see Mount Everest. Then here you can see maximum ozone layer. This, you know, brown layer is called as maximum ozone layer. What is the role of ozone layer, that I will tell you. How it is important also, that I will tell you. So here you can see that is the distance between this troposphere and stratosphere is around 50 to 55 kilometer. And above the troposphere, there is one particular sphere which is called a stratosphere, and the distance between these two spheres is 50 to 55 kilometers. And this particular layer, after the maximum ozone layer, which is called a stratosphere, that you can see in the graph, then up to about 20 kilometer temperature remains constant, then increase with increase in height. So here they have talked about, you know, the temperature that we can see on this kind of labels. Here from the stratosphere and above 20 kilometers, the temperature that we can see, that will be constant, and it will increase according to the height that they have given. Just a part of information, I'm going into the detail. Then the next one is ozone layer is in this particular layer. As we know that ozone layer is most important aspect of the environment. How it is important aspect, that I will tell you. But see, as I told you, before the stratosphere, there is one particular layer that you can see in brown color here. And that particular layer is called as ozone layer. Ozone layer means what, and why it is important, that I will tell you. Ozone layer is one of the important aspects or elements in the, or factors in the environment. Why? See, we get sun rays from the sun, and in those sun rays, there are certain hazardous things for the human beings. And this particular ozone layer will stop those hazardous things. And this particular layer will protect us from the sun rays, which are dangerous, which are not good for human beings. And this is what ozone layer is good. And what happened nowadays, the ozone layer is getting thin. Actually, it was very thick, but nowadays it is getting thin. And when it is getting thin, it is not protecting us from the sun rays, which are hazardous, which are dangerous, which are not good, or which are not suitable for day-to-day life of human beings or day-to-day life of n number of human beings and organisms on the planet Earth. So this is what this ozone layer is important one. So here what we guys have seen, stratosphere, this one is a just above of troposphere, maximum 50 to 55 kilometers from the troposphere. And here in between these two particular one, there is one layer which is called as ozone layer, and that will protect us from the sun rays, which these are the things which we guys have seen in this one. Hope you guys have understood. After that, we are going to talk about thermosphere, but time is already over. We are having second session or second lecture at 11:50, and your teacher will take that particular session. So you will get a small time of getting out of the session and getting in for the session. So at sharp time, I'm going to wind up my session. It is 11:40. So I get back to the home screen. I'll stop my presentation here and I'll get back to the home screen so that I can see all of you here. Okay, friends, I'm having one more session, one more lecture today. And that is my first session. It will start on 12:40 sharp. So till then, you guys have to wait. So in first session, we guys have seen the concept of environment, and I hope you guys have understood that. In second session also, we are going to continue from the last slide where we guys have stopped. So with this, I'm going to wind up my session. I also request you all to leave the session and join for the next session or second lecture of your teacher. And after that, you also come for my session. But link is same. Remember, link is same for upcoming lectures till 16th of December. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.